what they've seen of the hell, they will do the same mistakes. But coming to the question of Qadr, Qadr is the sixth pillar of Iman, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we Muslims believe, that Allah writes the Qadr, He writes the destiny. And people may object, many people ask this question, Muslims and non-Muslims alike, that if everything Allah has written in the destiny, that fine, whether this person is going to do good or bad, whether they're going to commit a murder, or whether he's going to commit a rape, or whether he's going to rob, or whether he's going to do good deeds, whether he's going to go to hell or heaven. If everything is mentioned, then where is our choice? Who's to blame? If I commit a murder, Allah wrote in the Qadr, I'm going to commit a murder, and I commit a murder. Who's to blame? Allah is to blame. So why should I be put in hell? And this is a very logical question. The reply to this question is that we have to understand the concept of Qadr and destiny. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has destined things, where a person is going to be born, in which condition he will be born, when will he die, which land will he die. But Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Fatir, chapter number 35, that whenever a child is born, the Fatir is bound on his neck. The moment he's born, Allah knows everything what he's going to do, good or bad, right or wrong, whether you go to hell or heaven. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has in the game. I'll give you an example. That suppose in a class that the teacher who teaches about 100 students for about 1 year, and before the examination that teacher predicts that this student, he will come out first in class, first class first, this student he'll get second class, that student will fail. Just an example, don't feel bad, brother. Now, after a few days, the examination takes place, and this student comes out first class first, this student gets second class, and that student fails. Now, I'm asking you a question, can the student who failed, can you object to the teacher that because you predicted, I'm going to fail, I have failed? Who's to blame, the teacher or the student? Who's to blame? The student. The teacher predicted this. Student, he plays hooky, he doesn't attend class, he sees movie, therefore he's going to fail. That student is okay, average. That student is very intelligent, does good, hard work. So teacher predicts in advance before the examination, this student will get a first class first, this student second class, that student fail, and the student comes out first class first, second class, that student fails. But because the teacher predicted, that does not mean the teacher is to blame. The teacher has taught everyone correctly and equally. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ilm ghaib. He has knowledge of the future. Certain things they are destined. He has said that okay, this person will be born in this land, on this particular date, he'll die in this land, in this particular date, etc. His surrounding, he'll be wealthy or whatever it is. But the choice is yours. For example, after you pass your 12th standard, you have a choice of becoming an engineer, or becoming a doctor, or becoming a lawyer. The choice is yours. You choose to become an engineer. So Allah already knows in advance that after you pass your standard 12th, you will choose to become an engineer. He's written in advance. It is not because Allah has written that you are choosing. It is because you have chosen, Allah has written in advance. The choice is yours. But Allah knows your choice. For example, if you come at a crossroad and there are 5 roads, road number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the choice is yours. You can either take road number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You choose road 2. It's already mentioned in advance in your destiny that you will choose road 2. It is not because Allah is writing that you're choosing. It is because you will be choosing that Allah has written in advance. So the choice is yours. You have a choice to earn your living, whether with good deeds, halal way, or with robbing, haram ways. The choice is yours. Now you rob. The choice was yours. But Allah knows in advance that this person, he would want easy money and he will rob. So Allah has written in advance that this particular person at the age of 25, he will rob. Who's to blame? You are to blame. But because Allah has ilm ghaib, he has written in advance. So the choice is yours. Allah has given us human being a free will. You cannot blame Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your misdeeds. So if you go to hell, it is because of your misdeeds. And if you go to Jannah, it is because of the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now let's try and answer this question. The purpose of creation from a different angle, from the angle of the creation, from the angle, from the perspective of the human being. That why have the human beings been created by Almighty God? And the reply to this question is given in the Quran, in Surah Araf, chapter number 7, verse number 172 and verse number 173. Allah says that He will bring out from the loins of Adam's children, may peace be upon him, all the descendants, and will ask them that, am I your Lord? And all will say, we testify that you are our Lord. And Allah continues, lest on the day of judgment they will say, we were unaware that you are our Lord, or lest they may say that our ancestors, they worship somebody else, they did shirk, they associate partners, and we just followed them, so they are the liars, we should not be blamed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before the human beings came in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought all the human beings from the loins of the children of Adam and ask them, who is the Lord? And all of them testified that there is one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is our Lord. And now is our test in this world. Allah says in the Quran, and I started my talk by quoting the verse of the Quran from Surah Dhariyat, chapter number 51 verse number 56. Allah says that we have created the jinn and the men not but to worship me. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. That we have created the jinn and the men not but to worship me. The purpose of creation of the human beings and the jinn is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now this word worship, if you analyze this English word, it is derived from the old English viewpoints, Skype, which means to honor. And if you read the new living Webster's Encyclopedic Dictionary, it says that worship means act of devotion, honoring the deity. Devotional acts honoring the deity. And if you translate into Arabic, the Arabic word is ibadah. Alladhi khalaqtu wama khalaqtul jinna wal insa illa liya'budu. The Arabic word for worship is ibadah. It is derived from the root word abd, which means a slave. And it is the duty of the slave to be obedient to all the wills and wishes of the master. So ibadah means total submission to the will of the creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibadah means total submission to the will and wishes of the creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And further, if we analyze that, even one of the forms of worship, as mentioned in the English dictionary, is glorification. As Allah says in the Quran, in Surah An-Nasr, chapter 110, verse number 3, Allah says, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ That means glorify the praises of the Lord. Glorify the praises of the Lord. So one form of worship is glorification of the creator, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one may ask that why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala require the human beings to glorify Him? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dependent on the praises of the human beings? See, irrespective, if all the human beings praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will not make him superior.